Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Naval Academy Preparatory School.
All right, everybody, welcome to Bristol Community College Bayhawks basketball. It's the women's Bristol Community College Bayhawks team who comes in today's home contest, 4-7, 4-4 in Region 21, taking on the Naval Preparatory Academy. Naval Preparatory Academy coming up and visiting Bristol Community College. I'm David Cardoza, and alongside me is the Portuguese cowboy himself, Craig Salvador, as we broadcast here from Bishop Conley High School, right next door to the beautiful campus of BCC, Bristol Community College, here in Fall River, Massachusetts. And Craig, on Saturday, we were here for a great win by our Lady Bayhawks. It was a huge blowout on Saturday. The Lady Bayhawks have been playing extremely well, and they come in here riding a two-game modest win streak, because they actually did win on Thursday night, and they won on Saturday. Two big victories for Coach Aaron Burrell, playing against the Naval Academy, the Naval Academy Prep School. Coach Aaron Burrell, is a former Navy man himself. I'm not sure what we got here.
Was there a technical to start?
Because we have no time. What is going on?
Katja Luna's at the line.
Is she practicing?
No. See, they counted a counted a basket.
I'm not sure what the violation is.
There's not going to be a jump ball to start.
Which is, I am not, why wouldn't they start with a jump ball?
Nope, looks like
the
they are
now. The game hasn't even started, and BCC's cut the lead
already
early on.
A lot of confusing. We were talking about the Bayhawks having a good game last time. Naval Prep coming in this game 0-5 currently. Misa Edwards with a great steal, and right off the bat trying to get easy points, but not able to get it. So his drive is number 40. Here's where the game gets fun, because the roster sheet online doesn't have the right players for Navy Prep, so this is going to be fun to call. Now it looks like they're attempting to reset the clock.
Having all kinds of technical difficulties.
Yeah, it's not just us this time.
Not just us this time. Thank God for that. Megan Parrish brings up the ball here.
I'm going to throw over to Misha Edwards, back to Parrish, over to Luna. She loves that three, but she's not able to get her first attempt. But rebound by Misha Edwards. They're going to try it again, looks like. No, throw over to Shannon Rosensteel. Back over to Edwards outside. Edwards dribbles over to Parrish. Parrish back
good
to Luna. Luna, second
Bayhawks
chance, but unable to get there. Misha Edwards pops it up for two, and that one's good.
Misha Edwards has been, she's been one of the better Bayhawk players lately. There for the offensive rebound.
That she is. We saw her go down with an injury for a short time last game, but she looks to be fine today, which is very good. Pass the outside, bounce back. You know, number 31 there, calling something on her.
So the Naval Prep Academy, located down there in Newport, Massachusetts, that's where our young men and women come in before they go on to the Naval Academy down in Maryland.
Parrish with the drive. Going up, gets stuffed. This was taken down by number 40. Long throw over, but can't connect, and that was going out of bounds.
As I was saying about the Naval Prep Academy, these are young women that are trying to become naval officers. So this is the preparatory school before they go to the actual Naval Academy in Maryland.
It's pretty interesting.
As a proud Navy member myself, and Coach Aaron Morrell.
And my friend's just coming back from the Navy, going to a party to welcome him back on Saturday. Is this a turnover here?
Yeah.
Gets stuffed by Parrish, though, but she's
actually
recovering.
Got the Navy shirt on.
Nice job representing.
Representing. Sorry, BCC today. It's against the UCMJ for me to root against my Naval Academy.
It's against to root against the Naval Academy.
I'm joking, but Anyways, 3-0 here.
Yeah, 2 minutes already down in this quarter.
Kind of a spastic, kind of a helter-skelter way to start this game off.
It was how the Bayhawks just go right out of the gate with the quick passing, and now it's kind of turnover after turnover right now.
Yeah, kind of sloppy play here at the beginning.
Now number 40 is going to the line.
You mean who we don't have on our roster? We have 41 and 42, but no 40.
Nope. Because the internet lies when it comes to the rosters.
Either way, nice touch, nice rotation from the line there.
That puts it in for Navy's first points of the game. This one going in and out, but it's going to stay out. Pass back over 35 to 40 now. She's driving, she's going up, and that one's in, and
nice,
that one's going to tie it.
Nice aggressive drive there.
Great drive by the Rams center. Long throw over to Edwards. Edwards for
Edwards
three.
Edwards to pop.
That one's going to just be a little overshot, and this one's recovered by the Rams. Slow dribble by Haven Coffer. And this one's
there
up,
she is
and
again.
She can't get that one. Lost it there, got it right back. She just can't do anything with it as Rosenstiel has it, passing it over to Parrish. Parrish, Edwards, and Rosenstiel, the big three of this team.
Yeah, they were the big reason they won on Saturday against Holyoke in a huge win.
Long throw over to Luna. Luna in the corner. She loves that shot, and
that
one is good.
And she got it. I was talking to Coach Amarell last weekend. I said, Katia Luna, she's not afraid to shoot, huh? He said that's the role he wants her to shoot.
This one gets kicked away and quickly picked up by Parrish. Long throw over. Edwards can't get it. Wasn't really expecting it. And this one's taken by the Rams. And they're calling a travel on
it. That's got to be steps.
So this one's going to be taken out now. Bayhawks ball.
Some of the other Lady Bayhawks to watch out for, Craig, as you know, Shannon Rosenstiel, she actually fouled out on Saturday halfway that third quarter. Remember, we didn't see her. She actually fouled out of the game, and that's why she was sitting on the bench. And she still finished with 22 points. She comes into today the sixth leading scorer in Region 21. So she is the top gun now for your Bristol Community College Bayhawks. And they formed a little bit of a good trifecta there with Megan Parrish, Misa Edwards, and also Shannon Rosenstiel. They become form kind of a big three there.
Yeah, so I remember last game we were saying throughout the majority of the fourth quarter, like, where's Shannon Rosenstiel? And I guess we just didn't catch that.
I guess we missed that one.
Yeah. I mean,
we were
they didn't hear
too
us.
Much fun.
They didn't hear us.
It's Katia Luna to inbound. Katia Luna.
Getting over to Parrish. It was Rosenstiel looking to drive, but Pierce perhaps calling a foul on number 42 right there. That is Erin Schaefer, one of the people we do know on this team.
We'll make it work, Craig. We'll make it work.
We'll try. Luna with a long throw over to Rosenstiel. Quick pass to Edwards. Edwards with a step and a dribble and a pass to Parrish, who shoots for three, but that one's not going to connect. So it gets taken by the Rams.
I like the movement, though. I like the shot. She was wide open for that. That's a shot she can make.
It was definitely the right idea, and we've seen her make threes like that plenty of times before. This drive, this one gets kicked away again.
I'm very impressed with number 40 for the Naval Academy. She's really tall, but she's got handle. She gets the ball on the outside, and she has the ability to take people off the dribble and get inside and get her own shot.
Right now she's the only scorer for the Rams so far.
Yeah.
The 3 points, the layup and a foul shot.
She's got the size. She's got the height.
Edwards now for a three, airballing. This one gets taken by the Rams. So, again, that number 40, dreaming it down. Now number 23 in. Don't have her name either. Bounce pass to 40. Driven looking to cross up Parrish, passing it back.
I think they fooled us with this roster and these numbers.
Yeah, well, all these numbers are so close together, but then it's like two people on the court right now who are actually playing. And they got what, 9 players, it looks like?
You never know with the Navy. It's like some undercover NCIS stuff. They don't want you to know who they are.
These are all aliases.
I'm ready for LL to come out any second. Nonetheless, 6-4, almost halfway through this first quarter.
This is Haven.
BCC going for their third straight win.
After a performance last game, definitely want to keep that winning streak going.
Yeah.
And I know 2 doesn't seem like a big winning streak, but you got to start somewhere.
That's for sure. Nice spin in the lane by Rosensteel. Couldn't get it to go.
We've seen her make that shot plenty of times. Kind of surprising she didn't get it.
Oh, she traveled on that one.
Oh, lost it, but Edwards has it now.
Call that, call that, ref.
Pass to Parrish. Parrish is driving without a license. Pass it to Rosensteel, but just overshot.
Rosensteel couldn't get it to fall there.
Long throw over, and they do the exact same thing, but this time it goes in.
And the other one, that's Haran Kofer.
Rams take their first lead of the game, 7-6 with 5 remaining in the quarter.
I'm assuming that's Haran Kofer, number 31 on our sheet. Oh, Rosensteel had all day. What vanilla defense there by the Navy.
Yep, making it look easy on that play. Taking the lead right back.
Shannon Rosensteel looking for another big game.
With Shannon Rosensteel, it's always possible for every big game. She's been having big games to every game pretty much.
That's a nice pass there.
You can't get it to fall, though.
And speaking of Shannon Rosensteel, she leads the team in scoring and rebounded with almost 16 points and 8 boards per game. So she's turned into the leading scorer for this BCC team on this young season.
What she does a great job getting open right under the basket and getting easy twos. And those rack up, definitely. Kacha for 3. This one up, down, and out. Deborah Banks tried to get the rebound, but just couldn't hang on.
And Deborah Banks had a hell of a game on Saturday.
Deborah Banks really stepped up last game.
Good presence underneath, hitting her free throws. Good to see her improvement.
Travel called on 32, Ariana McKenzie. Well, it was not a very good pass.
We got to find out who number 40 is, our mystery player of the day.
I'm surprised. Well, the way she's playing, I'm surprised she wasn't on the starting list.
She was out there for the tip.
So I was going to say, what, did they just sub her in, like, immediately?
No, I'm pretty sure she was out there for the opening tap as Megan Parrish goes to the line. Nice inbound play. Good look there by Luna and bound into Parrish. She was got stuck underneath the hoop there, but she goes to the line for 2. Good aggressive move towards the hole on the inbound pass.
Parrish puts up her 2nd. That one's able to sink. So 1-for-2 right there. 9-7 now. 4 minutes remaining in this quarter. Big bounce pass to the number 40. Pump back, shoot. Can't get it. Rosensteel almost with the board, but can't get it.
Can't get them second opportunities.
Oh, but she's going to get a third opportunity. And third time's the charm as that one goes in.
You can't let her get 2 rebounds in a row off her first shot.
Rosa still looked like she had it, but just rolled off her fingers.
BCC has to find an answer for her, for number 40.
A little swing action, Bayhawks. Luna almost lost it, but she recovers. Parrish surprisingly not giving it to Edwards, but Banks
nice
is underneath the hoop, and she's got that one for 2.
Nice hands by Banks to put it off the glass, nice and soft. Very good play there. Good job of Rosensteel from the top of the key to find Banks underneath.
Yeah, definitely. We always talk about Megan Parrish being a very unselfish player. That's a great example right there.
Definitely was.
Travel on that. So Bayhawks again getting the ball. An ADA contractor coming in the game.
You mean Rosensteel?
What did I say?
I think you said Megan Parrish. I thought you did. Did we talk about Megan Parrish being an unselfish player?
Oh, did Rosensteel get the assist on that?
Yes.
I must have missed that. Well, I'm surprised they didn't call a travel on a contractor on that.
Thought she might have been fouled there.
Maybe. It's a bounce pass without a lot of bounce.
It's Karen Byrne yelling out instructions to her team.
It was a bounce pass stolen by Megan Parrish. Gives it away. God, Christmas came early.
You can't let her do that.
Christmas came early. That was a gift to the Rams.
What did we talk about the other game, Craig? You can't let them get these easy layups. Knock them on their butt first.
No. Looked like maybe Parrish wasn't really paying attention. Maybe she thought her teammate was right next to her. Could get an easy pass, but it's the wrong color.
But right now, number 40... for the Naval Academy. She's doing whatever she wants to do right now.
But at the same time, she's kind of been like their only contributor.
Yeah.
We haven't been seeing a lot
of
them.
That's all they need right now.
Yeah. It's a tie game with 2:20 left, so it's been working. But they just can't shut her down. And this is a foul on Megan Parrish.
Oh, she definitely traveled.
Yep. She kind of went into a panic, didn't really know what to do, so just decided to put up a shot.
She was. Shannon Rose still to come in the game. She'll come in for Megan Parrish. I'd like to see who the primary ball handler is going to be. Looks like it's going to be Misa Edwards for sure.
Definitely, we see Megan Parrish as the primary, but we see Misa Edwards step up plenty of times. Long throw over to Luna. Luna pops a deep three off the tip of the rim, gets it back.
Luna has that quick shot, that quick release. I give her that.
Edwards for two, can't get that one. But
good job,
like
Banks
had
to get
rebound,
in there, but
she
can't hold on to it.
Long run by 40, overthrown. Look at Misa Edwards getting the boards.
Edwards looking to push it. Look, Misa Edwards must have stepped down the line there.
Must have.
So this is number 32. She's on our roster. Ariana McKenzie just inbound to the basketball.
To number 23, who is not on.
Number 31 on the court for Navy Academy is Heron Kofer. They're three.
Can't get it. Tips off the net. Luna has it. Giving it to Misa Edwards.
Naval Academy just can't depend on 4-0.
No. Luna thought about it, but gives it to Rosensteel for an easy two.
Easy. Driving baseline. Puts it up with her right hand off the glass and in. Good job by Shannon Rosensteel. She should be able to get whatever shot she wants underneath.
Like I said, she's been leading scorer for a reason.
Just seems to be their most all-around, their best all-around player. Their best all-around functional player. Fundamentally sound, everything. Oh. Passing the basketball. That's Heron Kofer.
That one's number two. Definitely, we see Rosensteel having the ball. She can shoot from pretty much anywhere for two, and again, she just gets wide open for layups all the time. You can see her shoot from the foul line as well.
Oh, that's for sure. She's got that mid-range jumper down.
That's a travel. You don't really see her pop up a lot of threes, but she really doesn't have to.
No, that's not her game. That's not her game. I like the way that she does play within herself. She plays in the interior. She'll take that mid-range jumper every now and then, but that's her game. She doesn't need to shoot from outside. Leave that to Megan Parrish and Cassia Luna, Misa Edwards. Do your job.
Exactly. Well, they're trying to block her off now, but she's going to pop up for two.
This is a one-on-five game.
No, literally, but Rosensteel still making that shot.
Awesome.
Going up and over the defender.
Awesome job by Misa Edwards, keeping her eyes up court, finding Rosensteel running the floor.
Rams are just trying to make a play now. This one for three.
Got to get the rebound. You got to block out.
She does have the rebound. She's looking for an open spot. She's going back for three.
Go get her.
Up for three. Can't get it, and that will be the end of the first quarter.
Well, so very closely contested, but very unsmooth first quarter, but nonetheless, 15 to 13.
Okay, back here in the second quarter now, the Bayhawks have a 15-13 lead, and the Rams, their only offense have been coming from that number 40. And as I say that, this one's in for two by number 23. We have attempted to get an updated roster as Luna tries to put up a three.
Oh my God, come on.
Rams looking for a pass game, but they can't get it. Almost trapped in the corner, but gets it away. Oh, she's wide open. She's going to pop up a two. Can't get it. Contractor looking to get the rebound, but knocks it out of bounds. But it's going to be the Bayhawks ball.
So I have a revelation. Number 40 is actually... Number 40 is actually Ariana McKenzie.
I hope you know that now, and that's going to be important. Rosensteel getting
that's
fouled.
That's a good matchup right there, McKenzie and Shannon Rosensteel. The two forwards for the Naval Academy and the Bayhawks, respectively.
Definitely with these two, it can be lead to some exciting basketball.
That's for sure. And at a sold-out Bishop Connolly High School today.
Oh, yep. I mean, I'm excited. I just woke up in the library about an hour ago.
Oh, man.
Hey, you know, you just get a busy day from class. I aced my history exam. Got to go to the gym and then take a nap in the library.
Merry Christmas. Congratulations.
It's a BCC life right there.
I'm overcoming a cold, like laryngitis.
Three up and
not
over.
Not my
Misa
A game,
Edwards.
But I'm here. I'm a trooper. Edwards handed off to Rosensteel there.
And they're calling a foul, it looked like. Foul's on Deborah Banks, so this will just be the Rams ball. Nice bounce pass under the hoop, but that one won't fall. Deborah Banks having it, giving it to Misa Edwards. Rosensteel wide open, up for two.
Oh, my goodness.
That was highway robbery right there.
Obviously a nice move. She had the lane. Unfortunately, it fell out for her. And I believe Coach Aaron Morrell with a timeout.
And that ball just a little too much English. Maybe some Spanish and French in there, too. That thing just somehow fell out.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Sometimes it falls out, Craig. 16 to 15 here early on in the second quarter.
Looks like our crowd is trying to start a wave.
A little phantom crowd.
Maybe like a maybe
phantom
some
players.
Phantom players, phantom crowd. Is any of this even real today, Dave?
No, we're in not reality. It's not reality Tuesday. Today's Tommy Tuesday. What a game by the Patriots last night. TB12 defined Father Time. 406 yards, three touchdowns.
He obviously had to perform. It was Tom Brady Day. It was 12-12.
Yes, 12-12. It was his day. Mr. Monday Night.
Mr. 202.
Rosensteel from the elbow where she likes it.
Contractor looking to get the rebound. I don't think she got it. Oh, no, she did. This one's going to stay down. Dave is trying to comprehend the handwriting on the paper he was given.
Offensive foul. Rose still clapping. She thought she had the shot in the end one, but no, nothing doing.
It's always unfortunate. You think you got it all and you just don't end up with anything.
That's number 35. That's Schaefer. Aaron Schaefer is number 35.
Davis had
Jeez,
some
wallowing.
Davis had some groundbreaking realizations. So he's trying to decode this roster sheet.
Yes.
Luna.
I'm not sure where our AD got the roster sheet, but he clearly screwed us over.
Yeah. Deborah Banks bound past the contractor. Throwing it up, can't get anything. Rosensteel, they're going to call foul on her. And they are. Otherwise, Rosensteel has been making some good plays, but just not getting the benefit of the calls.
Just wanted to point an addition to the Bayhawks roster. Deja Edwards is back. She's a freshman from Chicago, Illinois, went to Bloom Township High School. So she is back. She's a quick freshman guard and looks to add a little depth to Coach Amarell's team.
Well, they definitely welcome that space up on the bench, so have more players to come in.
Definitely. Can't have enough depth, that's for sure.
Yeah, exactly. That's how the men's team are so successful. Rosensteel just fighting to keep it.
Rosensteel looked like she's always fighting for the basketball. Got to watch out for those elbows.
Yep, she's an aggressive player, plays with a lot of heart.
17-16, the Bayhawks are better than this team. They should be stomping on their throat right now. I feel like they're just not playing their game. I think as far as the Naval Academy goes, they point to one player. That's Ariana McKenzie. How many shots has she taken? You just need to take her out of the game.
It's not really that either team is beating each other. It's that both teams are beating themselves. Like, both teams not playing the greatest of basketball.
Idea contractor, they're going to call her with a foul away from the basketball. So that's a foul on the offensive end.
That's the fourth team foul of the half. There's a bounce pass, a couple more bounce passes. 40, looking to drive. This one's up for two, and that one's good.
That's Sarah Morris.
Rams get a three-point lead. I think that is their biggest lead of the game. As Megan Parrish goes flying out of bounds. This one recovered by the Rams. She's looking to drive.
Santa Cruz.
She's looking to fly. She can't get it. Misa Edwards now. Now she's hustling back and down.
She waited too late. I'm not sure what Misa Edwards was doing. She had the numbers. She had Shannon Rosensteel to her left, met Parrish with the trailer, and she waited too late to commit to what she was doing.
And she was eyeing Rosensteel, but thought last second to give it to Parrish and just kicked away. There's nothing she could really do about that. Edwards breaks away up and over, so she gets it. Driving, they get off of her, so she puts up a two, and this one goes out of bounds. And this one's going to go away, so this is going to be the Rams ball.
Both teams turn the ball over. Both teams not playing sound basketball, that's for sure right now. Ugly game.
Definitely. And we talked about the Rams. They're coming in this game 0-5, and Bayhawks definitely don't want to be the Rams' first win. And she's going to step up to the line. 31, Haven Coffer, we believe. Coffer, whatever.
No, that's actually Sarah Morris.
Sarah Morris, so everything's kind of screwed up on this.
Sarah Morris is actually 31, yes.
Okay, she bricks the first one. So second one, she's going to brick it. That kind of sums up this game so far, Dave.
Hasn't been pretty. Very low scoring so far. 6 minutes to go here in the second quarter. I want to see more life. I want to see more life like we did on Saturday.
Edwards, long throw, nothing.
BCC playing too much hero ball, too many long balls that they don't need right now.
Yeah, you can make a small house with all these bricks right now.
A small. Oh, man. That's Santa Cruz with the basketball.
Bounce pass and.
That's Sarah Morris.
This has been the one play we've seen the Rams really do. We've seen the Rams try about two different plays, and even if they're not making it, they just keep trying it. But this one looks like it's going to work.
I'm not sure. How did she get down there? That's Shelby Cole.
There's just a lot of fumble on the field, or not the field, still thinking about the Patriots. It's a lot of fumble on the court, and then as Rams were recovering, she just broke down. No one went after her.
All I know is the Naval Academy has different numbers. Different numbers on their jerseys. This is like number gate.
Number gate?
Number gate.
Maybe they just swap jerseys to know to mess with
swap.
Us.
Jersey swap gate.
Jersey swap. I feel like that's a reality show.
That's true. Yeah, sure. Santa Cruz with the miss and the follow-up by number 31.
And ouch, 23
Sarah Morris.
23 to 16 now. Luna now from that side,
there
shooting for three,
there you go.
Her second of the game. And something about the BCC, Dave, is they were so hot out of the gate to begin this, and then they just went cold pretty much ever since.
Well, they're in the game, and that's all you can count on right now.
They're definitely in the game, but just like you said, hasn't been that pretty game.
There we go.
But
got
here
the
comes
numbers.
A good play. Goes up for the layup. She's got that one for two. Nice play by Megan Parrish.
See, I like that. Even though Megan Parrish had Rose and Steele on the wing, she committed to one thing. She knew what she was going to do, and she drives in aggressively, puts it about the glass and in.
Definitely.
Good job by Parrish.
Back to a two-point game.
Someone's got to front her.
Yeah, really, BCC did just get lucky that she missed that. She's made that plenty of times earlier. Luna thinking about two, but she doesn't shoot two, so she's going to get it. Edwards, she's going to put up a three. But nice play by Parrish, and she's going to put that one up, layup for two.
I feel like there's no defense being played by either team.
No.
Both teams letting the opposing team drive to the hole, and no one's putting a body, no one's stepping out in front or nothing.
No, probably just hoping that they're going to miss, get rebounds, you know.
That's what it seems like. No one's checking anybody. Megan Parrish was just able to get her own rebound, drive to the hole, and layup drill. So, I mean, even though it's 23-23, it's because both teams are playing sloppy. Both teams are missing wide open shots and a lot of errors that are, you know, because of nobody's fault but their own for both teams. So, yeah. Ugly play here in the first half, 23-23.
Yeah, exactly. We've seen Megan Parrish make plays like that plenty of times, but never so effortlessly as she did that time.
Yeah, that one was too easy. Yeah. She was able to follow her own rebound and drive right to the hole, and nobody even contested it.
Yeah, like she had all the time in the world. In that time she made that layup, she could have ordered a pizza, gotten room service, just done pretty much anything she wanted to in that time.
I just want to say what a great job with the rendition of our national anthem today by our own Lucy Cabral. Listen to the I Love Lucy show on Friday at 10 a.m. on bccradio.org. I actually got to listen to a little bit of the show, Lucy, like the last 10 minutes. Then you started playing music, and I was like, I don't know what the heck that is, but.
What kind of music was she playing?
I have no idea. I don't know what you call that. I like it.
.337 left in the half. 23-23.
All right, this is Santa Cruz with the basketball.
We're talking about the score being 23-23. Santa Cruz, the basketball has it. I think I said that sentence completely all over the place, but oh well. They call it a double dribble on that.
Don't quite see the energy by BCC like we did this weekend.
One of the players just falls for the Rams.
That's what I mean. Megan Parrish is there. She just puts her hands up. You gotta shuffle your feet. You got to get in front of her and play defense. You can't just put your hands up.
You said that was McKenzie, number 40, with the score.
I think Megan Parrish was scared of getting run over by a tractor trailer right there. Seriously.
Edwards and Luna just passing back and forth.
Where's the defense?
Parrish wide open. She's looking to drive, but they're going to call travel on her.
Too quick. You got to put the ball on the floor first. Basketball 101.
Well, still not as bad as the first week. Remember how many travels we saw then?
That's Sarah Morris down in the paint.
There. We've been seeing that play all day from the Rams. And like you said, just no defense. Edwards not even paying attention, almost nailed in the face.
Sarah Morris was able to plant herself in the paint.
Luna with the three, missing that one. Been inconsistent this game with that shot.
Got to get back on defense.
Yeah, exactly. You got to start playing defense. This one up for two, and that one's banked in for two.
That's number 32 with the score. Miss Shelby Cole. Parrish driving baseline there.
It's the bottom of the backboard.
She's hit the bottom of the backboard twice today, actually.
I mean, it's padded, so not going to hurt anything.
BCC on defense, giving up too many easy scores. On the other end, Ariana McKenzie driving baseline there. They're giving her too much of that baseline. She should not be able to do that.
Exactly. Well, Parrish is going to sink her first one. It's now a five-point game with 1:45 left in the half.
Hopefully we see a lot better second half. Coach Amarell will give them a talking to. Try to rise their spirits up a little bit. Got to rise up on a cold Tuesday night.
Exactly, that cold December Tuesday night, extra cold.
Yes. 12 days away from Christmas, the 12-day countdown starts. Lucy Cabral hasn't finished her Christmas shopping yet. Exactly. Minute and a half left, first half.
Bounce pass over to Luna. Luna looking to drive a little bit, passing it back to Parrish. Swings it over to Edwards. Edwards driving up for two. That one bouncing out the back.
BCC just cold from the floor, especially from the outside.
That was probably the most amazing accidental pass I have ever seen.
The Naval Academy missing a lot of shots.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, the Naval Academy, they're not playing well. BCC's given them two and three opportunities each time down floor.
Exactly.
Naval Academy's not shooting well.
Exactly. BCC is, and then there's making passes like that. BCC is not making rebounds that we usually see them make, and that's giving them extra opportunities.
Nice pass. Nice pass by McKenzie. Getting it over to Shelby Cole.
And like we said about McKenzie, how many second and third and fourth attempts has she had to make shots? That's pretty aggressive. They just said shooter right here. That's pretty aggressive for a basketball game.
Easy now. And I'm sorry, early, that was actually Heron Kofer.
20 seconds left. 33-24, this is the Rams' biggest lead of the game.
As soon as number 40, Ariana McKenzie, gets the basketball, BCC needs to be collapsing on her.
Exactly. Something we see from BCC defense usually is double teams, triple teams, and they just haven't been doing that. Especially with McKenzie, you really should be doing that to her. You know, try to seclude her off.
Well, someone needs to be on her like a cheap suit. I mean, she is like I said, she's able to do anything that she wants to do right now. And she's missed a lot of shots underneath too.
Yeah. We talked about we thought Shannon Rosensteel was going to be that matchup. It seemed like a perfect matchup.
Shannon Rosensteel is not getting the opportunities today.
No.
Nice pass by Edwards. Banks showing good hands underneath. Wasn't able to connect, but she'll go to the line where she's been a very good free throw shooter, Craig. She's one of their better free throw shooters. Don't have the percentage right here in front of me. Katia Luna actually leads the team in free throw shooting. 72% from the line.
But interesting about Deborah Banks was she was named to the all-tournament team for the NHTI tap-off. That's pretty interesting.
Yeah, that was at the beginning of the season, that their kickoff tournament, basically. Both free throws made. As we talk about Deborah Banks making her free throws, she makes both there. And that's the end of the half.
34-26. Dave, what do you think the Bayhawks have to do to get back in this?
They got to play better defense. They can't be afraid of number 40, Ariana McKenzie. They got to get in her way. They can't play this vanilla defense. You know, I seen Megan Parrish there on the fast break. Ariana McKenzie driving down. She just stood there and put her hands up and let McKenzie go right around her. Step on in front of her. Take a charge. I want to see them be more aggressive on defense, take more chances, you know, and create more turnovers. And you got to box them out. You can't let them get second and third chances. That's just basic. So hopefully they'll come out with more energy. And I think that's what I heard them scream earlier during the timeout is energy. They showed.
Back, ladies and gentlemen, to Bishop Colony High School. Back at you with some Bayhawks action coming in the second half. And during the first half, just sloppy basketball, really, Dave, going on. Bayhawks really beating themselves. Rams aren't really beating them.
Well, it seems like BCC is just not – they're just not playing good defense. I mean, they're allowing Ariana McKenzie, number 40, who is the leading scorer right now for the Naval Academy with 10 points. They're allowing her to dominate inside the paint. And she only does have 10 points, but she's getting a lot of opportunities. She's missed a lot of shots. The score is 34-26 right now. It could very well be 44-26 if the Naval Academy hit their little bunnies underneath the hoop. They've had a lot of opportunities, but they missed a lot of shots, too. So their shooting percentage isn't exactly, you know, stalwart. So BCC has an opportunity to get back in this game. They just got to play better defense. And I don't want to see so many outside shots, so many long-distance three-pointers by them.
We're talking about McKenzie. She's getting right back into this real quick. And Rosensteel with the quick rebound. Interesting about McKenzie, she's the only person in this game with double-digit points.
And you see Rosensteel with the aggressive rebound. That's what I want to see from BCC is more aggression. Sarah Morris with the rebound.
And as you said before in the first half, it just seems like it's a 5-on-1 right now.
That's
an out, up for a three.
Morris. That's Shelby Cole. Steps on Shelby Cole. Lead scorers for BCC in the first half. Shannon Rosensteel with 6 points, number 20. And number 23 with a pair of threes, Kasia Luna with 6 points. Megan Parrish just with 4 today.
Luna with a bad pass, easily picked off by McKenzie.
Good defensive play by McKenzie there. Up ahead, nice pass.
Looking for a good offensive play, but this one gets away. Nice job saving it is Santa Cruz.
Morris getting in there.
There's that matchup we were talking about.
I'll tell you what, McKenzie can do it all. She's got a good handle. She can pass the basketball.
Definitely looking like the Rams player of the game so far. And they're giving it right to her, and she's going to try to get that one in for two, but can't. Edwards looked to save it, but just couldn't. So this one's going to stay down for the Rams. Deborah Banks now with a rebound, giving it to Misa Edwards, who passes it over to Parrish. Parrish looking to drive. She's going up. She's got that
nice
one for two.
Nice drive.
Megan.
When Megan gets the ball, yeah, Megan, there you go. Don't steal that.
I'm running out of lines, so I got to take yours now.
Megan with the drive is right, and when she has the idea that she's driving to the hole, she takes that idea and runs with it literally. Nice lay-in by Megan Parrish.
Good pass there to McKenzie.
There it is. That's what I'm talking about. Collapsed on her. That's what I'm talking
about. Gives it to Edwards. Edwards with the turn. Edwards with the steal now. Good job working around Santa Cruz.
Nice change of direction by Edwards.
Edwards is down. Slow to get up, and she tweaked her knee.
That leg again, that ankle.
It's that same one that we saw last game, and she is in pain.
That ankle buckling her. If you're Coach Morelli, you got to get her out, right, don't you?
She's trying to fight through, but she cannot walk right.
You're going to have to call a timeout to get her out once they get the basketball.
Not exactly.
It's going to be an injury timeout here. And Misa Edwards with that leg. 88. Number 33, 80, a contractor, is going to come in for Misa Edwards. Misa Edwards hurt that leg on Saturday, Craig, as we remember. We remember her going down to the floor as she was shot. Ended up coming back, ended up running it off, coming and came back into the game and played well.
Yeah, hopefully we can see her back in this game soon.
Well, according to Coach Adam Morell, she has a little flair for the dramatic. Nice entry pass there by Parrish. Banks couldn't connect, though.
This Santa Cruz running down the court. Lost it, got it right back. Right now having the ball is Sarah Morris.
BCC looks all out of sorts on defense. I can't tell if they're in zone or playing man-to-man.
Nope. Megan Parrish with a rebound. He's saying that a lot. We'd be like saying that more, but like we said, BCC not playing great defense.
All I know is I'm glad to be here on a Tuesday night alongside the Portuguese Cowboy.
Is it 8 o'clock yet? It is. It's past 8 o'clock.
Well, after 8 o'clock, Craig Salvador turns from the Portuguese Cowboy to the Portuguese Terror. Time to terrorize that play-by-play now.
So Rosenstiel looking to get her second shot, make this a five-point game. This one's up, and that one's in.
Rosenstiel connects on that second free throw. Like you said, five-point game. Yeah. A lot of time left in this game.
Well, the Bayhawks are in no way, shape, or form out of this. They need to get some fast breaks and play better defense and just score more, pretty much. Like, I hate to put it that simply, but that really is just what it is. They need to play better defense.
Well, on both ends of the floor, they're not running their. I mean, they're not running their offense. We're not seeing the crisp ball movement. We're not seeing the motion offense. You know, we're not seeing. We're just not seeing the continuity that we've seen on Saturday.
Well, we saw early on, like first minute, we saw great passing by BCC, and then they just lost it right after.
BCC just looks to be, they're just teeing up shots. Every open shot from the outside, they're just teeing it up.
Yeah. And now McKenzie sinks both of her shots. Like you said, maybe just too much hero ball. Rosenstiel looking to drive, doing the play that she does oh so well as she banks out off the glass.
And I talk about BCC not playing the best defense. What was that? Shannon Rosenstiel got the ball and drove right to the hole for an easy layup.
Well, the Rams, they seem to just be playing. They're trying to do outscoring, you know. Other team's going to score 50 points. We're going to score 51.
Do you keep calling the Navy Academy the Rams? Are they the Rams?
They are the Rams.
Maybe the prep school is the Rams.
I don't know.
Because the Naval Academy is the midshipmen.
I asked someone earlier, and they said they were the Rams.
BCC with another turnover.
Well, that's not good, especially with a game this close. You want to get right back into this, take every chance you can. Santa Cruz bringing it up for Navy Academy. They're calling steps on her. Steps on number 35, Erin Schaefer.
Naval Academy doing a lot of travel, and it ain't by sea, it's by foot. Looking like the Army right now.
And BCC has to take advantage of that. But over to Luna. Luna not popping a three, instead trying to drive in two.
Luna has to know it. Every time she gets the ball out there, she doesn't have to. She can fake that three and dribble drive to the hole.
As she's going to drain that one.
Shutting me up. One, two, three. Luna for three.
Trying to get maybe the bounce pass to McKenzie. Rosa Steele trying to grab it.
And maybe that three could spark.
They were calling that on 32, which is Shelby Cole. So Luna's going to pass this in.
And Craig, maybe that three can spark BCC right now as the men's basketball team comes in. Just as they did last week. If you remember last Tuesday when we did the women's game, the BCC men's team came in and almost helped catapult the Lady Bayhawks to a win, although they came up short.
We definitely like that, seeing the schoolmates supporting each other. So, and we know something about the men's team. They can get loud, and that could be something that the Lady Bayhawks need.
That's for sure. They need a little kick in the butt right now as Misa Edwards comes back in.
Well, now that the men's team is here, the crowd is effectively doubled.
It's amazing how Misa Edwards looks like she's an amputee one second. Next thing you know, she's running back on the court like nothing ever happened.
And maybe she has healing factors. She's quick to get back in the game. Look at that, moving pretty well.
Easy lay in there off the inbound pass. Looks to be number 35, Erin Schaefer. For her first points of the second half. Parrish in the lane. Nice pass.
Nice bounce pass and banking it in. The boss, Deborah Banks.
The boss. The boss, Deborah Banks. Not to be confused with Sasha Banks, the boss.
That is exactly what I'm referencing.
I'm a Charlotte fan myself.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I love me some Ric Flair, so.
Yeah, I feel.
I love me some Charlotte Flair, too. Mm-hmm.
I feel like we don't have enough nicknames on the team.
Oh, we'll get there.
We will.
38-36, Craig.
5 minutes remaining in this quarter. And the Bayhawks, they're looking to tie it up for the first time in a long time this game. Oh. Long throw over to Edwards. Edwards thought about three, going for two. Can't get that one. And they're going to call foul, so Edwards is going to go to the line.
So talking to Aaron Morrell, he expects a lot out of Misa Edwards. Says he's one of his best handlers, one of his best handlers with the basketball. One of the, you know, she can create her own shot. And you know, definitely one of the go-to gals on the team.
Now she makes it a one-point game. Misa Edwards on this team, she's building a reputation of being one of the team's better shooters. Like we said, being a part of the big three along with Megan Parrish and Shannon Rosensteel. And perfect that round and ties it up.
Good job by Misa Edwards, draining both free throws there. Yep. We've seen BCC struggle from the line, but they've been a lot better today.
Santa Cruz pass back. Travels and more mistakes now from Navy
Academy.
Another
travel.
That was number 42. That was Haven Kofer. Again, more mistakes from Navy Academy. We've been seeing them do that a lot lately.
Edwards thought about it, kicked it back out.
Luna doesn't even have to think about it. She puts that one up.
Man. I guess she had the open shot, but.
Nice steal by Megan Parrish. Staying in bounds, keeping her footing. She's driving for two. She's taking them out. She's not going to get a shot, though.
I like to see Megan Parrish go to her left more. She drives to her right like a bat out of hell. And a lot of times she's successful, but I like to see her get, you know, get a little looser, get a little better with that left hand.
Yeah, we've seen plenty of top scorers where that's how they become so successful, is they're just as comfortable with their left hand as they can be with their right.
That's right. If opponents get the scouting report on you, they know you just dribbled to your right. You got no handle with that left.
Santa Cruz bounce pass over. Nice. She's going to sink that one too.
Nice entry pass there by Santa Cruz, getting the ball down inside to number 42, Haven Kofer. Wait for Kofer to get positioned down there on the block.
Yeah, but she's going to go to the line to try to complete the old-fashioned 3 points.
Naval Academy is showing good inside play.
He's going to get it.
Naval Prep Academy.
Long throw over to Edwards. Edwards driving, breaking
her
ankles.
Pass.
Contractor up.
Oh,
not able
contractor.
To get it. Oh, the men's team. They're frustrated for them. Parrish trying to steal that one. She does.
Here's Parrish.
Talking about BCC not playing defense this game, but Megan Parrish really stepping up on defense. And now
Edwards
just losing on offense, and now just sloppy basketball back and forth.
Edwards had the right idea, but she ended up right in the teeth of the defense, so ends up turning the ball over.
And then BCC just getting lucky on a bad pass.
So give credit for BCC getting back into this one. They were down by 8 at the half, so it's been a good little run for them.
We talk about their problem usually, Ben, falling up. They usually getting out of reach by the second half, but they are doing a good job. And last couple times we've seen them, they've been doing a much better job staying in the game and not giving up.
That's certainly right.
And I remember a lot of the first games we saw were barn burners, and now really staying in. And like I said, we got to see a really nice win on Saturday. Best game we've seen them play.
And that was probably their most complete team win. You know, they like I said, they've won 2 in a row. But their biggest, you know, we say that was their most complete team win. That was their most complete team win that we've seen them play. Actually, against Springfield Technical Community College, they had their best output of the season, 102-45 against Springfield. And then they followed that up with 77 points against Holyoke, 77-47. And today against the Naval Academy, only 38 today. So they have a big game coming up against Roxbury. Roxbury has been one of the top teams in Region 21. They've been the national champions. They play them at 5 p.m. at Roxbury, going into a tough environment down there. And then Saturday we'll be on the call when they play Great Bay Community College here at 1 p.m. at Bishop Conley High School. So those are the upcoming games before the Christmas break. And then we're on Christmas break for a little bit, and we'll resume play against CCRI at CCRI on 6 p.m. on January 12th. That's the upcoming schedule for your Bristol Community College Bayhawks.
Deborah Banks almost getting the end one, but she's just going to go to the line for 2.
Getting hot in here. Coach Amarell taking off his coat.
Deborah Banks, very good foul shooter. We don't see her take a lot of jumpers, but she's been very consistent at the line.
Deborah Banks been pretty underrated. If she can just gain position down there on the paint a little bit more, and Megan Parrish and Misa Edwards, they can kind of look for her a little bit more. She can score a little bit more underneath the basket. She's shown good hands. You know, she doesn't have brick hands. She's shown nice soft hands, nice touch around the basket. She gets fouled, and she goes to the free throw line. She's undersized.
She just has good form when she shoots.
For a front court player, she's undersized, about 5'8".
Santa Cruz wide open. Bounce pass to McKenzie. Seen this a lot this game. Back out to Cruz. Puts up a 3, and that one's good.
Oh, goodness. I was just about to say BCC playing better defense, collapsing down on Aaron McKenzie like I wanted them to do before.
And they're only calling that one a 2. So Banks over to Edwards. And looks like they're calling a foul.
And that three-pointer by the Bayhawks, that was Alicia Alicia Santa Cruz, number 23, that just hit that three for the Naval Academy. Navy prep.
They call the foul on number one, Jenna Vogler. Haven't seen much of her this game. Banks again from the line.
Lovely shot.
And again. So 2:22 left, so 1-point game. And Santa Cruz looking to drive, bounce pass into McKenzie.
Outside. Love the way BCC's playing McKenzie now. She's getting positioned on the block, but once she gets the ball, there's like three Bayhawks already on her, swarming on her.
We saw her, she goes for that step pack jumper, and hard to do that when you got people right behind you. So definitely, again, better stepping up. This one's getting away. It's going to stay down. But like we said, definitely playing McKenzie better.
That's Santa Cruz looking inbound for the Navy.
Misa Edwards playing hard defense on McKenzie. She's getting a steal.
And able to get the steal.
Now taking her time after running her way down. Trying to make a play. Easy pass to Parrish. Luna in the corner, up and under. Stolen by McKenzie. Gets it right back.
Not sure what Parrish was thinking there.
Cruz with the layup for two. Parrish trying her best to get the D, but she can't. Long throw
Santa
over to
Cruz.
Luna.
Santa Cruz starting to heat up now for the prep.
Edwards up for three, giving it to Contractor instead. It's a foul, and it'll be Contractor to the line.
They're going to call that foul on McKenzie.
We don't see Contractor take a lot of shots.
A lot of that. She doesn't make herself available like she did. Like she got decent position there on Ariana McKenzie. McKenzie fouled her. That's her third foul. And we're in the third quarter. So McKenzie approaching foul trouble there.
You're gonna miss both of her foul shots, rebounded by McKenzie.
Again, Craig, Shannon Rosensteel, the leading scorer for the BCC Lady Bayhawks. She's on the bench again. Please tell me she didn't foul out. Tell me that we didn't miss something like we missed on Saturday.
I don't think she fouled out.
She's not in the game right now.
I'm like 99% sure she did not foul out. But speaking of fouls, Contractor had one. Adia Contractor. We were focusing on Santa Cruz with the ball. And apparently Contractor got her second foul of the game. And this is Erin Schaefer at the line who made her first foul shot, looking to make her second. Make this a 5-point game. And she's not going to do it. Banks tried to get the rebound. McKenzie had it. McKenzie took one in the face. McKenzie says, I don't need this headband. She goes back to play defense. And she got swept in the face.
Let's see how she plays without that headband.
I mean, remember what happened when LeBron didn't play with his headband. He started to dominate even more. Edwards for three.
Bang!
That's good.
Bingo!
Picture-perfect Edwards.
And she dropped that one in.
With under a minute left in a 1-point game, the BCC men getting in this one minute left in the quarter. Still got a whole other quarter after this. There's a nice pass to McKenzie. Loses it, gets it right back. She's popping a three. Haven't seen that a lot, and she's going to miss it as Parrish gets the rebound.
She's gone cold, Craig. McKenzie's gone cold.
They're playing her better. Kacha looking to drive. She has nowhere to go, but a nice bounce pass to Banks. Over to Edwards. Edwards not putting it up, giving it back to Banks.
Right, shot clock winding down.
Yeah, 10 seconds left on it. Long throw over to Parrish. She's got to do something. They're telling her to shoot it.
That's the shot right there.
Now, Luna's
for three.
Up. Can't get it. Shot clock resets, and this is going out of bounds with 10.3 remaining in the quarter.
They got the shot they wanted, Craig. They were patient enough. They get the ball in the corner to one of their best shooters, Cassia Luna, but she missed it. But they'll get a new shot clock here.
Yeah, new shot clock with 10.3 remaining.
Shot clock is off right now.
Edwards throws up a two, just missing.
And I'm sorry,
tips off the rim.
I apologize, Craig. The shot clock is off because there's 4.7 seconds left, so they'll hold for the final shot here. And this one looks like it's going to go down the wire.
They're thrown in. They got to get a quick shot off. So Paris is going to do it, just missing.
Oh, she had the runner at the end, but couldn't get it to fall. It would have counted. Would have put BCC up by one, but she couldn't get it to drop. So it looks like we get a tight one here, Craig. 46-45. BCC playing with a lot more energy, a lot more spirit. And just seems like on offense, they can't really get anything going consistently, but they have come out the gate here in the third quarter, here in the second half, and have definitely played a lot better.
A big part of that is they're figuring out how to cover Ariana McKenzie, that double team and triple team, not allowing her to score as much and getting her rebounds.
And that's been the difference, because Aaron McKenzie's been the only threat. She's been the only offensive threat. She's been the only lady for the Naval prep to really be able to create her own shot and get inside and really dominate. I mean, Alyssa Santa Cruz has shown the ability to hit the outside shot and the ability to penetrate, but she's a little bit undersized. But other than that, who do you really have to worry about? Although I think Sarah Morris and Shelby Cole and also Haven Kofer, they've shown the ability to play inside and mix it up. But they have no dribble ability. They have no ability to create their own shot and get to the hole. So I think the only person you really need to worry about, you know, dominating you right now is Ariana McKenzie. And they've done a better job, Coach John Morrell, making some good halftime adjustments, you know, to be able to kind of take her out of the game. And McKenzie's been, she hasn't been shooting well this whole game at all.
No, we see one of the only plays Navy Academy has is it's a bounce pass to McKenzie in the paint who will take a step back and put up a two. And now that they're really figuring that out, we've seen Megan Parrish get some steals and Misa Edwards get steals off that. And then we also see people like Deborah Banks just getting behind her to prevent that back step. And it's really been paying off, and they've been following the rebounds because, again, McKenzie hasn't been shooting that well, that great. A lot of her points are coming from third and fourth attempts.
Exactly, and they've been kind of limiting that. Yeah. So I'm not sure what the story is with Shannon Rodensteel, the Bayhawks top scorer, but she's not in the game.
I could have sworn she didn't foul out.
She couldn't have. And that's, if we recall on Saturday, Coach Amarell got the technical foul. It was because Shannon Rodensteel had fouled out, and he wanted an explanation. So that was the reason why. Even though they were up by 30, it was just the principle. It was the whole principle of the situation.
We talked about Shannon Rodensteel being one of the best players here, and that's a huge impact not having her on the court.
It truly is. Like I said, she's their best all-around player. Either way, we have a tight one. BCC going to have to do it without their best player.
Navy Academy just trying to work around. Calling a foul, it appears. Yep, foul on Misa Edwards. And this will be taken.
And without Shannon Rodensteel in the game, Craig, you really don't have anyone to really match up against Ariana McKenzie.
You see right now, Misa Edwards on her. Misa Edwards only comes up to her chin. So you got the shortest player on the team covering the other team's tallest player.
See, and up and get over. It in. They'll get it in, McKenzie.
Nice pick set.
She's able to get through the defenders. How does she get through there?
Sarah Morris set a nice pick, allowing allowing McKenzie just to get through everybody. Long throw over to Luna. Luna putting up a three, not thinking about it, and that one's going to fall for, that one's just going to miss, pretty much an air ball. Now McKenzie gets a rebound.
Good effort by Contractor with the offensive rebound.
Good bounce pass up for two, and that one's good. Aaron Schaefer. And from a one-point lead to a five-point lead, 9 minutes remain. Parrish looked to drive. She just got stuffed. And
Parrish
like
showing no
that.
Fear going right at McKenzie.
We talked early on that we saw it seemed like everyone was afraid of McKenzie. No one was going after her. And now Megan Parrish really just throwing the body.
Well, Megan Parrish has showed no fear as far as driving to the hole going up against anybody. But I just felt on defense, you know, when McKenzie was coming down the lane or in the open court charging like LeBron, everybody was just getting out of her way. When she was getting in the paint, everybody was just getting out of her way, kind of just waving their hands. And now when she gets the ball on the block, everybody's collapsing on her, trying to cause havoc. And they're more putting a body on her now.
Yep. They're calling this one for Navy Academy. The men's team not liking that call. Santa Cruz crossing up, again, nice pick set. Cruz, the bounce pass just reached. And double dribble called.
Yeah, they call that double dribble. I know Coach Amaro doesn't want to lose to the Naval Prep today. Naval Prep 0-5, have not won a game yet this year.
And now they're calling a travel on Luna. So now we're back to the turnover game.
Luna not thinking, not putting the ball to the floor. Got to keep your pivot foot.
Looking for the bounce pass, giving it over. She's just got people around.
Wow,
her.
That was close to being a travel right there. And that's
and
a travel right there.
Santa Cruz.
That's a travel right there.
I guess if you can't call it on, Cole, you're going to call it on Santa Cruz. Over Luna with three makes this a one-point game with 8:12 remaining.
Cassia Luna.
Over.
Down inside.
Woman. This one's gonna take
again.
Forever
are these
to fall, but it does.
Are these ladies scared to foul? Are they scared to put a body on these girls? What are you doing?
And foul called on 35. That is Aaron Schaefer.
Was that Morris with the lay-in?
I believe it was. Yeah, it was Sarah Morris after the great pass by Aaron Schaefer.
That's what I mean. Morris is there, and then Adia Contractor just putting her hands up, letting her go right by. Shuffle your feet. Get in front of the offensive player. Use your body.
A three ties it as Edward puts it up. Can't get it. And this one gets brought down.
And you
so
see
McKenzie
how physical McKenzie is.
But she's got to be careful. She has four fouls. And like we've said, she's been the real dominant force for Navy Prep. So they definitely don't want to lose her.
BCC needs to kick it into high gear. They need to find that second gear. 7:24 left to play in this one. They're only down three. Haven't played their best basketball. They're down three. Time for them to find their second gear.
And something definitely must have happened. Shannon Rosenstiel sitting on the bench. She has her practice gear on. So, needless to say, probably might not see her back in this game. So,
and Shannon Rosenstiel sitting there. She's kind of jumping up and down in her seat. I'm not sure what's going on.
I could have sworn she didn't foul out. Parrish driving this down, passing it over to Edwards. Edwards thinking about it, gives it to Deborah Banks. And timeout call.
Timeout by BCC. And Shannon Rosenstiel is clearly upset.
Not sure if she's upset that she's not in the game or upset just how the game's going.
Shannon Rosensteel is from Sunrise, Florida, and I believe her father is in attendance today, so that could be a lot of what the frustration is right now. But again, like I said, I'm not sure why she's not in the game. BCC could really use her. They could use a score right now.
Exactly, in a three-point game, 7-11 remaining. Love to see her in.
She was getting a lot of easy baskets.
We talked about it. Navy Prep not playing aggressive D, so Shannon Rosensteel was getting a lot of easy layups, easy bank shots.
52-49. The Naval Prep school, like we said, is 0-5 on their young season thus far. While the Bayhawks are 4-7, they get a two-game win streak currently. Over the last five seasons, these two schools have played a total of four times, and they both have two wins each. So going for the tiebreaker in this one. As we're here at Bishop Connolly High School in Fall River, Massachusetts, you're watching Bayhawks basketball here on FBAR Media. Bayhawks looking for win number three in a row. They would love to have this win, Craig, and build momentum going into a big game on Thursday night in Boston, in Roxbury. That game at 5 p.m., two nights from now. Roxbury, a top team
long
in the region.
Parrish. Parrish driving. She's going up, up and around. Just can't get it to
fall.
She
must have heard me when I said she needs to go left.
Yeah, it came very close on that. And this will be in favor of Naval Prep now.
Yeah, ref calls a jump there. But it's going to be a possession arrow in favor of the Naval Academy. They get her inside. There's that double team.
Nice bounce pass.
But here's the thing.
Aaron Schaefer.
Here's the thing, Craig. They are collapsing on her, but they're letting everybody else free. And McKenzie showing the ability to find her open teammates.
So Edwards driving, pots up for two. Off the edge of the backboard.
Oh. Deborah Banks upset with that one. She got in there for the offensive rebound. Gets the foul. I was saying, Craig, Aaron McKenzie. She's getting double-teamed. They're collapsing down on her on the block. And that's allowing for...
You can see an Aaron Schaefer step up. Sarah Morris has had some great plays.
Yeah, Aaron Schaefer with the basket underneath there.
Santa Cruz has been playing pretty well. And this should get interesting now, as it appears Ariana McKenzie is now fouled out. So things now looking to get very interesting with 6:34 left in this game.
No, things are even. So Shannon Rosensteel, she's on the bench. She's fouled out, presumably. Either way, she's out of the game. And now Ariana McKenzie, who's been an offensive stalwart in all facets of the game, defensively, rebounding, offensive rebounds, defensive rebounds, points scored, assist. Who's going to step up for the Naval Academy to shut this game out as Banks misses there? Someone's going to have to step up for them.
I believe that's the first foul shot Banks has missed this game.
Craig, BCC has a chance to take advantage of not having Ariana McKenzie and her presence.
I would say fundamentally, I think now, especially with her gone, I think BCC now is a much better team than Naval Academy.
They should be.
Still just not getting rebounds.
This 8-year contractor, is she afraid to touch the basketball? Like, I don't understand what the heck she's doing right there.
And that one's up for two.
Contractor stepping in too late on that lay-in.
Luna popping a three like she always does and off of the rim. So Schaefer looking to drive. Stopping dead in her tracks. Still throws up a two, and that one's still going to fall.
That was the ugliest move I've ever seen, but she got it to go. I'm not sure what happened on that. Schaefer drives to the hole, stops dead in her tracks, looks to pass the ball back out. BCC freezes, and she puts it about the glass and in.
Yeah, she's saying, I don't have anyone to pass it to, so I'm just going to take it myself, and it worked.
But it wasn't like a functional basketball move. I mean,
no, it's like just a move out of desperation.
Like I said, the Naval Prep School, they don't have a lot of girls that can take you off the dribble and do what they want to do with the basketball. That was like, I don't know, 58-50. BCC seemingly should be winning this game right now.
Oh, definitely. Now, especially with McKenzie out. Honestly, when I thought McKenzie sat out, I thought BCC was just going to come at them like real hard, real strong, and start scoring left and right, but it's been the opposite in the short time she's been out. You know, because it's Naval Academy. They're getting fast breaks, and now they're scoring.
All right, BCC to take the basketball out here. BCC got to start getting aggressive now.
Down by 8 points with 5:50 remaining.
BCC, Naval Academy playing man-to-man.
Deborah Banks going to the corner, gave it to Misa Edwards. Misa Edwards driving. Deborah Banks for two, can't get that one to fall. Luna can't get the rebound. This one's taken by Shelby Cole. Big pass. Rough throw, and it's out going in. But she's going to get 2 points.
How about that?
Two shots.
Shelby Cole getting her girls riled up.
The foul will be on Megan Parrish.
Shelby Cole has shown the ability to dish the basketball. As Aaron Schaefer was a recipient, she goes to the free throw line for two.
I didn't see Aaron Schaefer do a lot during the first half, but now she's really been stepping up with some great passes and some clutch shots.
Well, they have a good little nucleus there with Kofer, Schaefer, and Morris.
What are they doing? They're just being overshadowed by McKenzie. But again, even then, McKenzie wasn't that great at shooting.
Yeah, Naval Academy out, Naval Prep out, playing man-to-man defense.
Edwards for three off the rim. Deborah Banks with a rebound.
Good job by Banks.
For two, the boss, Deborah Banks.
Deborah Banks with the rebound, the putback. Great hands, great ability to put the ball back up quickly.
Parrish almost had that steal. This one's up for two. Down. Big travel.
Another travel. This has to be a record.
We've seen this from Aaron Schaefer a couple times. She just kind of stops and doesn't know what to do with it.
What's the record for travels in a game?
76. I just made that up.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'm pretty sure they're at 74 now.
Long throw over to Luna. Luna looking to drive. Nice move, but that one's going to fall down. 88 contractor not able to get the rebound. And there's a travel.
Another travel bite. This one's going to be on Shelby Cole.
This is a big break for the Bayhawks now. But we talked about before, Ada Contractor's been having, she's been struggling this game. Again, not able to come down with their rebounds. Megan Parrish puts up a three. This one gets knocked down, so Cole has it.
Open look, but I don't like the shot. You had an open lane there to drive. I don't like the shot. Nice up and under move there.
Contractor knocked it away into the arms of Luna.
Who's going to step up for BCC with Shannon Rosensteel on the bench again for the Lady Bayhawks? Someone has to step up, and you can't be – it's not going to be prayer three-pointers.
No, we're still seeing Megan Parrish and Misa Edwards have a good game, and Deborah Banks again trying to step up. I think ADA Contractor really has to step up.
You can't take your time here. You got to show a sense of urgency. Yep.
Parrish nice underhand, but it's not going to fall, but she's going to draw the foul.
Nice move there by Parrish going to the hole, breaking down the defense. Scoop shot, just couldn't get it to fall in.
And the foul is on Aaron Schaefer.
Megan Parrish, second leading scorer on the club. Can't get that one to fall.
Been getting about half of her foul shots in this half. And she'll do it there, get one for two.
Needed that one, Craig. A lot of time here, under 4 minutes to play. A lot of time to try to get back into this one.
Only six points down. They definitely got this. They can bring it back.
Got to take chances. Got to get after the basketball. Got to take chances if you're BCC. BCC also matching up, man.
Navy Academy just looking to get some passes going. Looking to drive. And
oh, what a pass.
Pass nice that pass. Somehow worked. And that one went in. I believe that was number 42, Haven Kofer.
Yeah, but a nice pass by Shelby Cole. She's been a very good passer for them. A lot of good entry passes. She finds her teammates. Yeah. And she's an emotional leader. And the Naval Academy is up by eight.
Really caught Misa Edwards off guard. Looked like she kind of tried to block it, but she just was not expecting that one right through her hands.
Naval Prep School looking to come into Fall River, come into Bishop Conley High School, the home of the Lady Bayhawks, and get their first victory on the season.
0-5, snap the Lady Bayhawks winning streak.
Naval Prep School, they don't have a destination. They don't have a distinction. They're not in a Region 21. They don't have a conference. You know, the Naval Prep is where they come for 1 year. It's a preparatory school. And then after that, they go on to the Naval Academy in Annapolis, Maryland. Where they become midshipmen. And then after that, it's on to the fleet. Again, Coach John Morrell serving in the Navy prior to his collegiate coaching career.
We talked about before, this is technically his first year coaching the Lady Bayhawks, right? Because last year there wasn't a team.
Last year he wasn't able to field a team. But in the off season, from last fall till now, Coach Amarell has been on a recruiting mission, and he'll stay here up until April, and he'll be doing a lot of recruiting after the season before he goes back to his home where he resides in Florida. But he's done a good job so far. Four back-to-back wins. His Bayhawks team has been playing a lot better. They're in this game, and they're still not out of it, Craig.
No, only 8 points, three minutes remaining. They can still come back. Edwards now looking to drive. She's up, putting up a two. That one's going to fall.
Good job. Cuts it to within six.
Well, we've seen Misa Edwards with some nice little drives like that, and they've been working.
Got to put the heat on them.
Santa Cruz just looking for something. That's
going to
kick
off. Get after that basketball.
Scramble for the ball.
There
Megan
you go.
Parrish has it.
Take the ball middle. She does.
She's driving without a
nice
license, and she's going to score for two.
Cut it to within four as the BCC men's team over there screaming defense.
Foul on Katya Luna.
Referee saying that Katya Luna stuck her leg out on a Navy player.
I was going to say Santa Cruz is in dangerous territory, straddling the line, almost on the verge of out of bounds, but then that happened. Cole is driving, Megan Parrish goes down.
They're going to call an offensive foul.
Yeah, they're calling charging on that.
They're going to call a foul on Shelby Cole.
So good job for Megan Parrish taking one for the team.
61-57, Craig, 2:20.
Still got a lot of time.
Key possession here for the Bayhawks.
Exactly. Long throw over to Edwards, able to get that one. She goes up for two. This one tipping off. And Cole has it for the rebound.
Media Contractor's got to get in there and rebound.
Well, they haven't been seeing a lot from Media Contractor. It's kind of a ghost on the court. Cole now, nice pass. Over to Schaefer under the hoop. Can't get anything on that shot, though, so Banks has it for the rebound.
Good defense there by Bristol.
Luna puts it up.
Oh, my goodness. That would have been a doozy. But she couldn't get it to drop.
Cruz is cruising. Giving it over. Now one's up for two. Can't get it.
Goodness gracious.
And foul on Misa Edwards. Misa Edwards is not happy with that. And perhaps some confusion on the court.
Either way, it's a foul.
They're trying to decide whether it was on, if it was on Deborah Banks or on Misa Edwards.
Doesn't matter at this point.
Were either of them close to fouling out?
Well, if it's number 42.
It's Haven Kofer.
No, it's number 15. The foul is going to be on Misa Edwards. That's going to be her third. So the Bayhawks take a timeout here.
So they're deciding to give it to Misa Edwards. 4 points, 91 seconds left.
So BCC playing a lot better in the second half. Both teams right now without their top scorers, Ariana McKenzie for the Naval Prep and Shannon Rose still for the Bayhawks. So minute 31 left here in the game. And we'll see if this is a two-shot foul here. Or it looks like we're in a one-on-one situation. 14 fouls for the Bayhawks. BCC men's team is in attendance. And they came off a huge resounding victory on Saturday against Holyoke. And they're on a win streak for themselves. Seven-game win streak for the boys basketball team.
Definitely a force to be reckoned with in their division.
Yes, sir. All right. We're getting ready for this last minute and 31 seconds.
Going to the line is Haven Kofer. She's going to get two shots. And she looks like her first one.
And, she jumps Haven, a
little. Haven Kofer's someone who's kind of stepped up this quarter. We've seen her play a lot better than the rest of the game.
I love the Navy spirit, Craig. I love the way they're all congratulating each other. They're all trying to uplift each other. She makes both free throws.
Yeah, and they have reason to uplift each other as they got the got two of them right there. So it's now a 6-point game, a minute 25 left. Parrish puts up a three, lofty.
That's
and it's
good.
Now a
Megan
three.
For three. And you know who that was, Craig? Megan Parrish. One possession ball game with a minute 15.
It was a clutch three by Megan Parrish. I was just more focused on what's happening now.
BCC match it up. Match it up, man. Out court. Get to stop the ball.
Whose contractor got to get in there. Cruz has it now. A minute left, down by three.
Oh, they're going to call a foul on Luna. That would have been a nice steal. She swatted the basketball.
Nope.
Cassia Luna with the foul.
That'll be the fifth team foul for the Bayhawks. It'll be her third.
She took a good chance there, though. She went after the basketball.
Remember a game, I believe it was a couple of weeks ago, and you were just screaming for the Lady Bayhawks to foul because they were, I believe, just down by 2 points.
Well, Coach Amorell said
they couldn't get a possession.
Coach Amorell said they gave up. The last 25 seconds of that game, they gave up.
Yeah. And that's important. Coming off, right,
gonna
there.
Get Bricking the rebound.
Them. Megan Parrish has it. She's running down with a minute left. She is looking to drive. Looked for the end one, but looks like she's gonna go to the line.
Megan Parrish knows one speed, Craig, 1,000 miles per hour. And she's going to head to the free throw line.
She's going to get two shots, and again, as one of the better shooters, she has a very good chance of making this a one-point game with less than a minute left.
She's one of the better, well-rounded players on the team. She needs to take this game into her own hands. I feel when she has the ball in her hand, she's in control. She has the ability to drive to the hole. She has the ability to pass the ball. She can dribble.
She can dribble, she can shoot, she can pass. She's just an all-around player.
When she pushes the ball up the court with pace, she has a sense of urgency.
Knows how to drive and knows how to put up a three.
Right, and she's not a one-dimensional player. And they need to count on her right now as well as Misa Edwards.
And they're debating whether or not number 32, Shelby Cole, has had five fouls, which would mean she'd be out of the game. And, yep, so Shelby Cole will be out of this game. So she exits, and it looks like Haven Kofer will be ready to get in this game.
So Shelby Cole is going to foul out, one of the better players for the Naval Prep School. She's been really good. She's been a leader on the court. Showed great passing skill. She has the ability to find her teammates. Like I said, one of the big emotional leaders on the team, Shelby Cole, goes out for the game. Parrish kind of struggling from the line today, Craig.
Yep, missing the first one and.
Yeah, not her best
it's
game.
A pretty crucial shot now. She able to
gets
sink
that
one. It's now a two-point game.
She wills that one in.
Bayhawks playing very aggressive defense
oh,
right now.
Oh, goodness
Parrish
gracious.
Got to
get
steal.
Back, contractor.
Misa Edwards looking to cover. And she's going to be driving.
Loose basketball.
Edwards has it. Edwards falls. And it looks like they call on a foul. It is. There's a foul on Haven Kofer. Misa Edwards going to the line, it looks like, and she has a very good chance of tying this up.
Well, the Navy Prep School, Craig, has had the lead for the majority of this game since the first quarter, or since the second quarter rather. They've controlled this game. They've been in the lead, and now they could be getting a little bit tight. Got to make free throws down the stretch, though. Misa Edwards with a miss. Had a chance to tie the game. Yeah. Can pull it to within one here. So
pressure's definitely on.
Both teams in the bonus. Both teams with five fouls. So it's going to be a free throw game from now on. Who's going to make the key free throws down the stretch?
And she can't get
can't
that
Can't get
one.
Him to fall. Edwards misses both free throws.
Bayhawks got a good break, though. So this one's going to stay down with 48.3 left. They really need to make a shot.
BCC gets the basketball and a new shot clock. Underneath,
Luna gives it to
contractor.
Up and over, Banks has it. And Banks is going to be going to the line, it looks like.
BCC
and she will, and we have talked about Deborah Banks with her being a great foul shooter. Chance to be very clutch right now with 45.2. Can tie
better knock
up.
On wood, Craig. Better knock on wood.
I'm knocking.
Because
so
you're
time.
The jinxer.
I'm the jinxer.
You are the
I have a lot of faith in Deborah
You are
Banks
the
right
jinxer.
Now. Timeout now.
The name of the game is faith. BCC has kept the faith. They've hung around. And they have a shot to tie the game here because they haven't played their best basketball. They've been down by 8. They've been down by 10. But they've crawled. They've fought. They've done everything they could do to stay in this game, despite not playing their best game.
We've seen them give up before, and they're certainly not that team anymore. Staying in this game 100%.
Craig, they had 26 points at the half. They scored 100 points against Springfield. They scored 77 points the last game. They're averaging 62 points per game on the season, and cover where they've come from, At the beginning of the season, they weren't scoring that many points. They're averaging 62 points per game of the season. They now have 61, so they're near their season average. So they've had a good offensive output, not a great offensive output, but they've had a decent offensive output here in the second half.
Yeah, well, it started out as a really bad game for both teams. It's actually been really coming down to the wire and been a pretty hard-fought game towards the end.
And the Naval Prep School looking for their first victory.
Yeah, so a lot of the line here. Naval Prep trying to get their first victory, like you said. BCC trying to keep their winning streak alive. So 45.2 left. Deborah Banks will be going to the line for two.
So Deborah Banks, as she waits, you know, take a deep breath, Deborah. Take a deep breath. These are free throws right here that make you the boss.
She gets the first one. You could hear a pin drop as she shoots it.
Banks could tie the game. You could hear a pin drop here at Bishop Conley. She calmly takes both free throws.
The boss.
Like a boss.
The boss, Deborah Banks. Coming super clutch in this game. 40 seconds left, tie game.
You don't need to.
Cruz is running everywhere.
You just need to play your defense. You need to just play your defense. No stupid fouls here if you're BCC.
Nope. Luna looking for a steal. Can't get it. Number 21.
Allow
That's
the Naval.
Alexa Pater. We haven't seen her all game. Edwards gets a steal.
Another loose ball.
But now Cruz has it. Volger with the shot. The three can't get
rebound
it.
Rebound by contractor.
Deborah Banks, the boss with the rebound.
I think if you got to hold up. You got to hold up.
Oh, just rushing it.
What are you doing?
And this one's going to stay for BCC.
Luckily for BCC, you got to call a timeout if you're Coach Amorell. He'll take one here. He'll take one here.
11.6 remaining, tie game. Deborah Banks having two clutch performances back-to-back with that rebound and then those two foul shots we just saw.
I wasn't about to concede. You've been calling her the boss all game. I wasn't about to concede that until she made those two free throws. Key pressure situation. You're down by two. You know, under a minute to go. Crowd's hyped. You gotta make those free throws to tie the game, and she did it like a boss. Banks. Sends them both home. Now with 63-63. If you're BCC, you gotta hold on for the last possession. You don't need to shoot early on. Yeah. Get a good look. Get something going to the basket. The Naval Academy, they might foul you. You don't know. Get something going to the basket. You don't need a 3-point shot. Unless it's wide open, but I want to get something going to the hole at Megan Parrish if I'm BCC.
At this point, you just got to score.
Yep.
And again, talking about Deborah Banks, we were talking about the big three before with Edwards, Parrish, and Rosensteel, and that big three looking like a core four now.
Could be. Deborah Banks is slowly improved. I just like to see her get more involved offensively. You know.
Yeah, definitely.
Coming to the ball more, getting her shot.
Yep. But slowly but surely, getting better.
But she's played her role. She's known her role, and she's done a good job in it. And Coach Amorell, I know, only expects more steady improvement for her as the season goes along.
So BCC looking for something big with 11.6 remaining in a tie game. Quick pass. Luna
for
three.
That's exactly what they didn't need to do.
Nope. Now
bad shot.
5 seconds left.
3 seconds.
Cruz looking to score.
Time.
She's driving. Throws it up to no man's land.
They should have called it. Was gonna. There had to have been a foul on that play. Wow. BCC got away with it. There was a lot of contact there as Santa Cruz went to the hole. This one goes to overtime, Craig.
We have bonus basketball here at Bishop Colony High School.
I want to point out, and I know Coach Amorell drew this play up, and I talked about it. I talked about it before they went back on the court for that final possession. They didn't need to shoot that three-pointer. They shot the ball with about 9, 10 seconds left. Gave the Naval Academy a chance to go down and score. And they almost, it looked like there might have been a foul at the end of that, drive by Cruz. Like, what in the heck are you doing? BCC got away with one there, I'm telling you.
Yeah, definitely. Because Katja Luna, she had a great inbound pass right to Misha Edwards, gave it right back to Luna. Luna
and
looked
she
like she
was open.
Swung.
She was open, but I mean, you don't need that shot. You
there
gotta time, hold it.
There
hold
are time,
it.
Yeah, exactly. There are times to put up a three, and that just wasn't that time, especially when you really only need a two to win it. You need
exactly.
a point to win it.
Exactly. And you shoot it, you miss it, you're giving the Naval Academy a lot of time to go back the other way, and a lot of freaky things can happen. So luckily for BCC on their end, they get away with one there, and they're going to have a fresh, presumably 5 minutes. Yeah, 5 minutes will be put on the clock here for overtime. So if you are watching on FR Media, channel 95 on your dial, you got a good one.
And bonus basketball coming at you from Bishop Colony High School.
Yep, it's a bonus.
So the crowd and attendant getting their money's worth.
If you're a sports fan, you're a big fan of Boston sports, come and get some Dirty Water on Thursdays, 4 p.m. You can listen to the show. It's called the Dirty Water Sports Hour with Cardozo and Andrews on bccradio.org as we talk everything Patriots, Bruins, Celtics, and the Red Sox, as well as everything else, too. We'll be talking about a big Patriots win as they get the inside track for the number one seed. Big win.
I saw my boy Chris Hogan with that huge run.
Oh, that was huge. What a dagger. That I needed that.
I was watching with my friend, and we joked around. We said Tom Brady's going to throw – I said Tom Brady's going to throw, like, an 87-yard pass to Chris Hogan. And then he threw, like, one for 72. So I was, like, so close.
So you called that.
I did call it. I was freaking out. I was like, I told you.
I couldn't believe I seen him. I seen him wide open. I was like, please just don't drop it.
Exactly. Chris Hogan has so much potential.
He does.
He's a great player. He can become an even better player. Especially the Patriots team that really needs to step up with a lot of injuries.
But they get a lot of good little weapons. But we're getting ready for second half action here.
Tip up. Aaron Schaefer has it.
If you're BCC, you got to continue that momentum.
Hey, can't slow down even in overtime. This one's going out of bounds, so the Bayhawks will take it.
Naval Prep School all out of sorts now. Yeah. They've been making a lot of mistakes, especially without their leader on the floor there, Ariana McKenzie. One of them anyways.
That's something they've been on and off with a lot during this game is just mental errors. Edwards got a lane open. She's going to put
job.
That one up for two.
Good job from Misa Edwards.
Bayhawks
not to settle for that jumper and drive to the hole and drop it in for the deuce.
Bayhawks take the lead now in overtime. Bayhawks' first lead in a long time in this game. Not since the third quarter, I believe.
Well, ever since they've been matching up man-to-man or woman-to-woman, they've been playing a lot better. Not sure what kind of defense they were playing before.
Edwards was wide open on that pass. She's going to try it again. And...
Well, looks like Edwards on the drive.
Offensive
clearing out with her left hand. Driving, she's sweeping the defender.
Yeah.
Or pushing off with her left hand. As she's driving to the hole, can't do that.
Nope,
they call up. It's a fourth foul on Edwards.
You know, 4 minutes left. That's going to be tough. Bounce pass under the hoop, up for two, but nothing.
And what did they call there?
It looked like it was an offensive foul, but I'm not sure.
Well, the ball just sailed out of bounds.
I don't know. Parrish looking at Edwards, and she's going to give it to her. Long throw over, Luna wide open, not afraid to put it up, and can't get it. Contractor with the rebound, though, and nice pass to Edwards. She's going to try to put up a two, but she can't get it.
Banks will go to the line.
Banks going to the line again.
Banks is such a good free throw shooter. And we have an injury on the court.
And it looks like it's going to be Luna. Looks like another ankle injury.
And they don't need this right now. They don't need this right now because they don't have the woman power on the bench right now. Rosensteel's out. She's out for the game.
Let's see how she walks. It appears to be walking okay.
I swear, these girls freak out like they're dying. Next thing you know, they're okay. Typical woman.
No, don't women have healing factors?
You know, the act. Every woman has an actress in them, I think. Oh, God. Keith Thibault's going to be getting phone calls tomorrow.
Get that womanizer off there.
And I better not be seeing hate on Twitter tonight for that.
All right, Deborah Banks up into line. As I was saying, Craig, she could be a weapon down there on the block. They can get her the basketball. She, at the very least, is going to get fouled, and she's shown the ability to make these free throws. So.
Just
and
like that.
And she gets it a drop, yes.
Making it a three-point game.
These are two more big free throws. They can make it a two-possession game here, Craig.
Doing her typical routine, up and over the head, five bounces. Spinning a little. What's up? She's going to miss that one, but maybe
Contractor, that's huge! Oh, my goodness.
Almost the chance to get her first points of the game. Megan Parrish almost with a great steal. Cruz sailing across everybody.
Nice bounce pass.
Nice bounce pass
by Cruz.
That's Alexis Pater. We haven't seen her a lot.
No, that's her first points right there. And what a time to get him.
Yeah, and overtime. Make it a one. Megan Parrish open all day. Can't get that one to sink. Contractor can't get the rebound. It's going out of bounds. It's going to... BCC is not going to get the call.
Wow.
Coach Amarill not
happy. They're going to call it off BCC.
The bench isn't happy. The men's team isn't happy. The crowd's not happy. Nobody's happy except Navy Prep.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Megan Parrish was open on the wing right there, but she had clear as day a lot of paint.
And the foul call looks like.
She had a lot of real estate to drive on the other end. I don't like the shot selection by BCC right now.
This would be a foul on Adia Contractor. And this could be big right now. As I believe that's Aaron Schaefer to the line. Schaefer now with a chance to give her team the lead. 3:04 remaining. She's going to get the first one. That's going to tie it.
You see the Naval Academy playing together, and you see them working the ball inside.
That one's short, not going to go in. It's like a violation of some sort, so it's going to be Bayhawks' ball regardless. So 3 minutes remaining. This game is tied. Both teams with five team fouls. Nice move by Edwards, but
just
gets
stuffed.
Oh,
what a block. Nice block. And she grabs it.
And it looks like they're going to call another foul on Adia Contractor. Two fouls the Bayhawks didn't need by Adia Contractor.
That was a nice block, though, by Sarah Morris.
That was, and able to hang on to it.
And able to hang on to it.
So, speaking of Morris, she's going to the line. Chance to give him the lead.
And she steps up, yep, and she steps up to the line. All six is on the board right now.
Yeah, he's going to miss the first one.
Big miss there. Under 3 minutes to play.
He's getting ready, puts up the second one, makes the other one.
They're going to call a lane violation. They're going to call it on the Naval Academy. They'll wave that off.
And that is a huge hit right there.
Yes.
Parrish looking to drive. She's got three people on her. Puts up a shot.
Parrish split the defense right there. She'll step up to the line.
Yep.
All free throws going from here on out. Both teams in the bonus in overtime. That foul is going to be on number 33. Who we don't have.
I think that's still Adia Contractor up there. She's going to miss the
okay,
first.
Okay, so they haven't changed that.
She's going to brick the first one. This is what we talked about Megan Parrish. She's averaging only one of her foul shots. So she's struggled lately from the line. And she's able to bank that one in.
Well, she gives them the lead there.
So 1 point with 2:40 left. Cruise up and over.
Nice
block by Edwards.
Nice defensive play by Edwards there.
That is huge. Sailing it over to Parrish. Parrish looking to drive. She's going to throw it up off the glass. Contractor has it.
Megan Parrish is having one of her toughest games that I've seen this year. She's having a really tough time of it. She's not getting anything to fall.
Look at the stain on Sarah Morris's face. So Luna's going to throw it in. Looking for something.
Got to get the ball
Bounce
inside.
To Banks.
Banks underneath.
She's gonna throw it up.
Can't get it to
Contractor
fall. Contractor. Oh, my goodness. Oh.
Two big plays just missed.
Adia Contractor gets a lot of offensive rebounds and
Hasn't been doing anything with them. Folger with the pass. Throws that one away. Contractor gets it.
That was a poor shot there by Morris.
That is a bad pass to the Parrish over her head out of bounds.
Sloppy play. BCC needs to slow the game down, get into their offense, and be more patient on offense. They let one or two people touch the basketball. Next thing you know, the ball's flying up towards the hoop from downtown.
Exactly. It's still 1 point, so 1:56 left. Both teams in the bonus. And there's a lot of people on this, and there's a lot of people on the court who all have four fouls.
Yeah, getting down to the nitty gritty.
Parrish looking to steal, couldn't get it. Up and over, into no man's land, out of bounds. Big break for BCC, just a really bad pass.
This is the first we've seen of Jenna Vogler. Number one, throws it out of bounds.
I haven't seen her a lot, and you don't get a lot of minutes. You don't want to do stuff like that. Nice pass to Parrish. Parrish looking to drive.
Misa to Megan. The M&M connection. And
like
Parrish
that.
Will step up to the line.
That's something that Megan's been very good at this game and just in general, just drawing fouls. And that is already the fourth for Jenna Vogler. And she's going to sink her first one. So this makes it a two-point game.
Like I said, Megan Parrish not really connected too well on her free throws, but she's making when it counts. That's all that counts.
So the second one, she's going to make it, and that is clutch.
And now, Craig, she's made her last three, and they've been key as they're up by three.
Yep. Navy Prep needs a three to tie it with 1:30 left. Cruz steps back. She's going to take that three, and that one's going to be overshot. Deborah Banks with a rebound.
Good shot by Banks on the rebound.
There you go. Deborah Banks making key rebounds this game. Misa taking her time, something she needs to do. Parrish thought about that play again, driving it, but didn't, giving it back.
Gotta be
now
smart.
She's gonna
Gotta
do
be
it.
Smart.
Puts it up for two. This one's gonna
That's
hang.
Good.
That one's gonna hang a while, but it's gonna fall. This is now a 5-point game with 1 minute left.
Megan.
Schaefer, she's
nice
gonna
fish
throw that
there.
With
nice
the left
move,
hand for
and
two.
She gets the foul.
And she's gonna get the foul, so she's gonna look. Maybe
Craig,
look to
nice.
Get the line.
Craig, nice little fake there by Erin Schaefer. Driving to her left to push it above the glass.
And she's going to go to the line, make this a three, make it a two-point game.
But Craig, let me tell you, talk about Megan Parrish and her struggles today and how she's had a tough game. She has the last 5 points for BCC, three of them on free throws, three of them from the free throw line where she struggled, and then that last jumper.
And now, Dave, Adia Contractor is fouled out. So BCC has four women on the court.
Boy, I'll tell you what, if they can pull it out now with a less than a woman advantage.
They might just have to get the ball and really just try to run down the clock.
Well, Naval Academy on a power play now.
Yeah. And it's going to be a timeout call, very smart. And, yeah, like you said, it looks like Coach Amorelli is going to try to start up a power play here. So it will be the Bayhawks ball. With 1 minute left, a two-point game. Four women on the court, 4-on-5 now.
We'll see if the Naval Academy can do something with that, with having a woman advantage. I mean, 5-on-4 basketball, you have the numbers. You should be able to create opportunities for yourself. But Coach Amarillo has to get imaginative on defense now. He has to have some kind of defense because you can't play man-to-man anymore.
No. A team like this team now that likes to run, they can run all around them. You don't want to do that.
And the Naval Academy.
Let that happen if you're the Bayhawks.
Yes, and the Naval Academy, they've shown the ability to find the open lady. You know, they have a lot of players who are unselfish. They have good passers. So we'll see. We'll see what Coach Amarell can draw up as far as playing defense, because that's what it counts.
That was actually Adia Contractor had 3 fouls in this overtime. So that's where that came from, and now she's out. A minute left.
So if you're BCC, you got the ball on offense now. Take your time. 30 seconds on the shot clock. A minute to go. Get a good shot here. Take the shot clock down. Get it down. Don't shoot early in the shot clock. You want to lengthen the game right now.
Yeah, exactly. Trying to run down the clock.
Or shorten the game, however you want to look at it. Yep. You got to...
Take your time
and get a good shot.
That's what Edwards is doing, taking her time. Luna hanging on to the ball, not putting up a 3.
Get something going
Edwards,
towards the...
They got a good passing game going on. The Navy not too aggressive on defense. Up to Parrish. Luna for three.
She's
going to make that one. 36 seconds remaining.
Luna!
It's a 5-point game. That is huge.
Dagger.
That is clutch, and that one gets away, and that is a travel. BCC's ball, 31 remaining.
Dagger three.
What a game this has turned out to be, Dave.
Bing, bang, boom, Luna. And now the Naval Academy prep school with no choice but to foul right now. And BCC with 4 players on the court, Luna. I thought she was crazy when she shot it, but it was a long distance. I mean, it had some distance on it, and it was nothing but net.
And matching her name, you could call that a moonshot.
That's a shot of the game right there. Well, this one not over yet.
No.
This one not over.
But Edwards is attempting to try to put it out of reach. With 25.9 remaining. Now, not able to sink either of them. And this is where Navy could be really, really dangerous. Crews running everywhere, throws
it
behind her back. And Deborah Banks with the rebound. And now with 11 left.
Around the back.
Edwards and Banks really just got to hang on to it now, and it looks like Lady Bayhawks are going to hold on to it.
That's it. Good job to play keep away. That's going to be it.
And that's going to win it.
Wow.
So great comeback victory for the Lady Bayhawks here. A lot of key players and just a lot
BCC
of key roles.
Doing it without their best all-around talent, Shannon Rosensteel. Unbelievable! What a comeback here for the Bristol Community College Lady Bayhawks, coming back here tonight and winning 74-69. Craig, wow, what a game!
And a lot of potential people for this, but who do you think our Bayhawks player of the game is?
I'm going to give it to Cassia Luna. That big three. Stuck a dagger in the hearts of the Naval Academy.
That was probably Katja Luna's most clutch and her biggest three of this season. We've seen her throw up a few, so
yeah, Deborah Banks
deserving.
Deborah Banks had some moments. She hit those 2 free throws down 63-61 underneath the minute to play, about 40 seconds to play. She hit those 2 big free throws, but Katja Luna was huge. I mean, that three-pointer was the money shot, and she sunk it. And that's the one that said goodnight, everybody, as we're about to wrap it up. So Cassia Luna is going to be our Lady Bayhawks player of the game.
Definitely. So the Lady Bayhawks extend their winning streak to 3. From FR Media, this is Craig Salvador for Dave Cardoza. We'll see you next time.
Good night.